Ron. I'd like to welcome you to our guest artist interview with Alicia Sable, who is an RU alum from 2001 and playing the role of Gwendolyn in our production this spring of The Importance of Being Earnest. And also with Alicia is Kathleen Harshberger, who is an RU alum from 1980 and playing the role of Lady Bracknell. So welcome both of you, and I appreciate your joining us for this interview for our Curtain Up dinner in a few weeks. As Radford University graduates, I'd like to start by asking you to look back at your time at Radford and reflect on those experiences that may have contributed to some of the successes that you found in your various career paths. And Alicia, if you'd start.
Well, I started coming to Radford University as a child. I was part of the community arts school. So I started a long time ago, and from that I sort of progressed into the music department, and I studied there for my whole 4 years here. And while I was there, I had a teacher, Betty Turner, who said, you know, I think you should really take advantage of the opportunities in the theater department and the dance department. And from there, I sort of went right into the theater department and did plays and took acting lessons and acting classes. And when it was time to graduate, I felt I was really well-rounded, if that makes sense. I was able to sort of go out, and I ended up deciding to study some more after, but it really opened my eyes to see what was out there and what I could sing, and I could dance, and I could act. I use those words a lot. Good attempt to. But it really exposed me to so much, and being from this area as well, I feel like this university really provides a lot to the community as far as culture and art and those type of things. So yes, it really gave me the foundation, and I should say it prepared me greatly.
Good. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Kathleen?
Well, that's wonderful, Alicia. I didn't know all of that about you, so we're all very interested in, excited that you're here. Well, I had done a lot of theater before I decided to come to Radford University and do a degree. So I had, I just wanted to do it. My husband encouraged me. At that time, Dr. James Hawes was the head of the department, and so I decided to come as an adult student. I always like to say I was the oldest living graduate, which is the name of a play. So I really enjoyed my time here. I really enjoyed the students. Along with Dr. Hawes, I helped found the original First Nighters, which is what we're doing now, just under a different name. We're calling it Curtain Up now, but in those days we did First Nighters. And I'll segue a little bit. For a while, I was a fundraiser for the college. For about 4.5 years, I raised money for this college. And one of the things that the people said to me was, we'd like to go back to having those nice dinners, nice events, and so that's when Carl and I got together and put our heads together and decided to do this event. And I'm digressing, I know, but I think that's all right. I think all of my career since I left Radford University has been involved in one way or the other with the arts, and they've also been involved with large groups of people. To give you an example, my husband and I started The Long Way Home, the outdoor drama, and we dealt with large groups of casts and large groups of people. And then I went on to the University Club at Virginia Tech, where I dealt with large groups of people and did many, many, many events. And I always considered the events as being productions. In fact, I used to say, all right, time to go on stage now. And then my final result of that was about 15 years ago, I decided to open my own etiquette and protocol business. And I went to the Protocol School of Washington and was trained to do that. So I've traveled all over the country and all over the world doing that, and I usually address very large crowds, upwards of 200-300, sometimes even more. An example of that closer to home is the protocol dinner that I do for Radford University graduating seniors every year. And that's 200 students plus. So I'm used to dealing with large crowds, and I directly attribute that to my training here at Radford University. That doesn't mean to say I don't get nervous. I do get nervous, but we don't show it, and we use that energy to get on stage and do it.
Very good. Well, we do have a name for that task now. Production management is a lot of what you have kind of corralled all of this into, and it kind of revolves around that. Very good. Alicia, you've made a career as a working actress for well over a decade, and much of that time in New York City. We would love to hear some of your experiences, some of your challenges maybe, and some of the rewards of that journey.
After I graduated from this program, I studied further in New York City, and I went right into film and television right away, which was very interesting because I was such a theater person, and it was quite a challenge to adjust to that because it is very, very different. I mean, the fundamental, you know, is the same, but it is very, very different. And I would say that I was just horrified when I first went to a TV set. But over time, and what made me more comfortable was the commercials. It's very interesting. Sure. Doing commercials really sort of helped me overcome that challenge. And we took film classes, and we had on-camera classes. So those definitely, I remember thinking back, what did we do in class? Okay, oh my goodness. Okay, ooh, okay, yes, I know. And so that worked. And then I moved on. I kind of found my way back to theater. And I did a Broadway show in 2008. I did the revival of Gypsy with the brilliant Patti LuPone.
Yes.
She's lovely. And I was Marjorie May, and understudied Agnes in that production. And it was just magic. That's all I can say about that. I did just pure bliss. And when that closed, I sort of found my way back into the TV commercial world again. And then I ended up on Amazon's very first scripted comedy called Alpha House, which right when I got to Alpha House, I thought I knew what I was doing when I came to film and TV. Oh boy, I really had miles to go there. So a challenge, I guess, would be I was always, every time I think I've got this under control, I'm like, oh no. There's always so much more to learn. You always learn. So you always have to keep those skills. You always have to go to class. That's a big challenge, to keep up. And everything evolves. Everything changes. And so I did Alpha House for 2 years, and I would co-star with John Goodman, and I played his bossy little chief of staff, Tammy Stackhouse, who, interestingly, she was from this area. So it was really nice that I could. They said, do you have a dialect that sort of, that you could pull out? I said, oh, do I? Oh my goodness. And I had to go back and relearn everything drilled out of my head. So yeah, so those are the things that I have been busy with.
That's what keeps you young.
That's
right?
I hope so. Let's hope it stays that way.
Kathleen, 1 year ago, you and your husband, Dick, appeared as guest artists for our production of Anything Goes. Can you talk a little bit about the differences in the two roles and which one you might feel closer to?
Oh my goodness gracious. Well, it's amazing that it was 1 year ago. Can I digress a little bit?
Sure.
You said that it keeps her young, because I have to say this. When she was very young, a young child,
here we go.
She appeared in The Music Man with my husband Dick Harshberger.
Oh, wow.
Dick was Professor Howard Hill, and this wonderful young person was
Amaryllis.
And I remember her so distinctly as just being such a wonderful young actress.
Oh,
and you haven't changed much, actually, as far as looks are concerned. Yes. Yes, Dick and I were privileged to be asked to do that role last year by Wesley Young. Dear Wesley, who is also directing the show, and I find him just a brilliant director. Let me add that in there too. The differences I think are in the language of the two plays. The role that I played in Anything Goes was a very fun role, although the characters might be considered the same, since both women really are determined that they're going to get a fine marriage for their daughter. So in that respect, the roles are much the same. But the language is much, much different. Lady Bracknell, of course, is a tour de force for any actress to play. And I'm privileged to play it. Many men, by the way, many, as you know, many, many very famous men have played the role of Lady Bracknell, who is a force to be reckoned with when it comes to getting her daughter married to the right person. So which one I feel more affection towards? Well, I think I just love every role I do, really. It's like you love all your children and all your grandchildren equally. Right now, I'm in love with Lady Bracknell because I'm playing her, but it was great fun to play Mrs. Harcourt last year.
Good. Alicia, in 2000, you appeared in the Radford Theater production of The Boyfriend, directed by Chuck Hayes. What impact did that production have on you?
It had a major impact. That was the time I mentioned earlier that I sort of really got involved in the theater department. And, you know, I came and I was in Wesley's acting class, I believe, you know. Wesley's acting class, acting 101. And just walking through the hall, I think I saw a flyer for auditions for The Boyfriend. I said, oh, a musical. Oh, it's right up my alley. So I came in and I auditioned and I got a part in the show and I did it. And, you know, I remember he was so supportive and sort of just opened. I was always a fan of musicals to begin with. But since the Music Man was the first musical I had done, and I had done an opera here, a child's opera, with the music department. But that show really, as a little bit older, I really thought to myself, this is kind of where I want to go. I want to go here. I want to do this. And Chuck was so supportive and sort of told me about all these different programs. And I ended up going to a program in New York City that he had told me all about. And I flew up and he helped coach me a monologue, helped me pick a song, fully prepared me for the audition in New York City. And I went into the audition and I ended up attending the American Musical and Dramatic Academy. And I graduated and went right there in the fall. Right. And and I did wonderfully there. And that was because of my, like I said, preparation here. And just, that's the impact that show had on my life.
Marvelous. Kathleen, you've talked a little bit about this, but I'd like for you to go into a little bit more detail in terms of, after graduating from Radford, you embarked on a number of different career paths. And could you talk about how those opportunities evolved and one led to another?
After I graduated from here, I remember I was a married woman and I had three children. So that was always my first focus. You mentioned TV and TV commercials. I actually did that too. I had I formed a small company and I had a stable of talent to do TV and radio commercials and voiceovers. And I did that for several years. And one of the reasons I could do that was because it allowed me to stay home and not go out into the workforce, but to stay home so that I could continue to be with my family. After my family grew, I ended up going to the University Club, as I said, at Virginia Tech. And that, I always said, it was time to go on stage when I would do these productions. I always was interested in etiquette and protocol all of my life. And after about a 15-year stint at the University Club, I decided to open my own business. That is where, I remember actually at the Protocol School of Washington, they said, if you are shy in front of people, take acting lessons. because that will help you, get up in front of people and do your work. I was fortunate enough not to have to take acting lessons because I was comfortable in front of people. That probably was the biggest gift that I had when I started my own business because, as I said, I do talk in front of very large groups of people.
Good.
Hope that answers your question.
It's good. Thank you. Alicia, you graduated with a major in music and have now moved into TV, film, and Broadway. how did this transition occur and some of those challenges along the way?
Interesting. Like I said, I graduated with that music degree, that foundation, and when I got to the conservatory in the city, I was able to really dig into the acting and the dance part of my training. I mean, I still had a great deal to learn when it came to music and singing, but I do feel that I was so prepared in that area, so grounded, I guess, or my roots were in that area, that I could really focus on those other things, and which I had now really grown to love. I really was like, couldn't wait to get into them. I don't know so much about the dance, but I was a good mover. And so that was a challenge. The biggest challenge that I still find today, because I like to think of myself as a professional auditioner, not necessarily a professional actor. I find that you have to really be ready on the drop of a hat. You really have to be ready for a change. You have to be ready. You might not have an audition for a musical for 6 months, and then guess what? You're going to have one Tuesday. So let's hope you've been practicing all this time. You really have to keep it up, and you have to be ready for people to throw different things at you all the time. Be ready to do something. You have to keep that bag of tricks nice and full. And I actually, when I arrived here, I was so impressed with the students, because I was a brand new member of this team, hopping on this merry-go-round that clearly was a well-oiled machine at this point. And I thought to those guys didn't miss a beat. You all didn't miss a beat. You kept I left that rehearsal that first night and said, oh my goodness, I've really got a lot of work to do. I'm going to catch up with these kids. You guys have prepared them so well. And that's really interesting to see, because they already have that ability that I still struggle with today, to sort of go with the change. Let's throw a whole new person in the show and just go and keep on going. So, yeah.
But you are starting that journey with much less time.
Yes.
I am.
Yes.
Good. The guest artist program, we've spoken a little bit about, but it has a long and storied history that dates back to the 70s with its founder, Jim Hawes, initiating that. The department has always recognized the importance that this program has in bringing professional artists to campus to work side by side with our students. Can you talk a little bit about those experiences thus far in working with them? Kathleen, I know you've been in the rehearsal process for several weeks now. If we could start with you.
Yes, I would love to talk about the students and the rehearsal process. You know, I think the students today are better and better prepared than when I was there. I don't know why I say that, but I just felt it last year and I feel it this year. They're much more serious. They have a much more professional grounding. They are being taught to act and prepare in professional ways. Wesley is a stickler for detail in a very positive way. His patience, his knowledge of the play, his patience with the actors, all of us, is exemplary. The students are serious, though. They're not goofing off. They're serious when they walk in here to rehearse, and they're working very, very, very hard. I think the results will be shown tonight when the audience sees the play.
Terrific. Alicia, your experience has been much different, as you referenced, starting rehearsal just 3 days ago. Would you speak directly to some of those challenges, and in particular, what it means coming back to work with students as a guest artist versus as being a student?
I'll just kind of piggyback on that. I was blown away when I arrived. And I remember I got off the plane and I thought, I'm honored to be here. I could not be happier to come back here and spend time with, I mean, this is a win-win for me. I know this is not about me. This is about the students.
It's all about your artist
program. I'm aware of that. But I'm making out like a bandit in this situation. I get Wesley, I get Lean, I get you, I get Rafford again, I get parents, my family are in the area. I'm just getting everything. And it's really sort of just to see all those students, to see the students' passion and energy and dedication that they're putting into this. And it's just really, I'm proud. I'm proud to be, and to have graduated from this department, from this College of Visual and Performing Arts. I get so happy I can't even speak. That's how I feel. That's what it means to me. So it's very special, and thank goodness for this program. I wouldn't have this if I didn't get to come back. And I hope that the students are enjoying it. I hope they're happy, and I hope I don't disappoint them. I can say that too, and it's inspiring.
Well, we were very excited to have both of you back, and I can't tell you over the years how many times I've heard, well, Alicia's doing well in the
oh.
So it has come up on a semi-regular basis,
oh.
So you're not forgotten. And I have one last question for the two of you. I know you've been rehearsing in rehearsal costumes for a while, but recently we had a photo shoot yesterday, as a matter of fact, where you were in your actual costumes for the photos. And I'd like to ask you, one, what is it like portraying a Victorian woman wearing some of these fabulous dresses?
Do you want to take it first?
Or do you want me to take it first?
I all of a sudden felt very gorgeous. I felt like, maybe it's the corset that's keeping me so upright. But I felt very stately. Would that be the word? But like we were talking, giddy on the inside would be another thing. This is the first time that I've done a piece in this period. So this is actually very new to me, this story, you know, the costumes and Monica. And I actually find, if I can say, I think it's amazing. As the students were helping me dress, in the dressing room, I had one student said, oh, I did the pleats. One student said, I do. I thought, how amazing. All these students came together to build this costume.
Right.
And they
That's
just.
Right.
It just was something else. It really was. And the amount of time they put that costume together in a very short amount of time.
For the photo shoot.
I was blown away.
Well, we have been rehearsing. The females in the cast have been rehearsing with rehearsal clothes. And every night we get laced into our corsets. Some people complain about corsets, not in the show. But we like it, don't we? We're forced to sit properly. It gives us
nice
a certain authority.
Yeah.
My role as Lady Bracknell, who is well, she's called a Gorgon in the play. Automatically, I become Lady Bracknell when I have that corset on. The costumes are brilliant. Monica Weinzappel, who designed the costumes.
Beautiful.
And Kathleen O'Neill, who built them. And directs the students in the building of some of them. They're brilliant. They're beautiful. I think the audience is going to be enjoying the costumes just as much as anything else there, as well as this fabulous set. So yes, it's an amazing experience to step into those costumes. And then, of course, you've got to be able to move in such a way that you're not knocking yourself over or knocking anybody else over with the size of them.
We have sleeves.
That's right. That's right. They're amazing costumes done by amazingly talented people. And let me just add something else. I have been so struck by how excited the faculty are to be doing the show. Wesley is over the moon about directing the show. Monica is over the moon about designing the costume. She's always wanted to do it. Kathleen is over the moon because of what she's doing with it. And it is such an inspiration as an actress to be around these people who are so thrilled to be doing it. And I have to say that about them. Your faculty, Carl, is exceptional.
They are. Thank you.
Are exceptional.
Thank
I have
you.
Proper grammar if I'm going to play this role.
Well, I'd like to thank both of you for joining me this morning and sharing your experiences with us. We look forward to seeing you in our production tonight of The Importance of Being Earnest by Oscar Wilde. Thank you.
Thank you, Carl. It's been a real pleasure. Thank you.